Hello and welcome to Kraaft It Live. I am your host, Heather. I'm pretty sure I am. You know what's funny is as soon as we do all this lead up to this point, and then as soon as we get to here, I go, now what do I do? I click that button. That's what I do. So hi, welcome to Kraaft It Live. I hope that you are ready to have some messy fun. Well, actually, we've had kind of all the messy fun we're going to have on this project. We're tonight or today. This is still daytime, right? Anyway,
Yes, it
today
is.
we are going to be putting the finishing touches on our very large canvas that we've been working on all month. If you've missed any of those episodes, please check the link below if you're watching this on YouTube, and if you are watching it live, don't go anywhere. Stay right where you are, okay? So, there's so many things to talk about today before we get started, but the first one that I want to talk about is the color challenge, because we did mess with turquoise and red this month, and we had a whole lot of fun, and so did a whole bunch of other people, and they tagged their projects properly, and we gave away to the winner a engraved mug, or what was it, wine glass of their choice
Wine
from
bowl.
Jay. Yeah, I know, it's a wine bowl. Yeah, it was big enough to be a wine bowl. Anyway, Jay is going to be presenting you with that shortly after he gets the other orders in. So those are things that Jay is working on, and it's been a lot of fun. This whole month has been filled with lots of blingy, pretty colors, lots and lots of projects. But you know what? I'm getting ahead of myself. I want to introduce you to my wonderful friends who join me every single week and make this show absolutely worth watching. And that would be Sherry Whitfield and Sylvia. So Sherry, why don't you say hi?
Hi guys, happy Tuesday.
And Sylvia?
Hi everybody, terrific Tuesday.
I just love these ladies, and I'm so grateful. Not only have they helped me tremendously with this show and making it enjoyable for you to watch, but they've also been working on the website. And you may notice, if you've come to the website today to watch, you may notice that there's like a banner right up at the top of this whole page, and that banner tells you that right now we're under messy reconstruction of the website store, and you can take advantage of that right now with a 10% coupon. I'm trying, working really hard to get you a bigger coupon. If you are a newsletter subscriber, you're going to get one, I promise. But we're trying to get the website all squared away first, so that's what we're waiting on. But in the meantime, you can actually take advantage of 10% off everything, and if you do so this month before the reconstruction is over with, I'm including a free gift in every order. So keep that in mind. What's the free gift? You want to
What
know what the
is it,
free gift
Heather?
is? I don't know yet. Those applause came at the perfect time. Woohoo! She doesn't know. Yeah, no, seriously, I do have a couple of ideas, but what I'm going to do is privately message the person who orders and say, would you like this or would you like that? So that's how
Oh,
it's going to
that's
go.
really
Cool.
sweet.
Yeah. So not only do you get to save 10% off during our messy mess time. Anyway, you'll also get something personalized free gift for you. So enough of
Awesome.
that chit-chat junk for now, don't you think? Let's move on to the art, huh?
Hey, let's.
Okay, let's. Why don't you go
Let's
ahead
do.
and do your
Okay.
thing?
Let's say hi to everybody who's visiting with us today and watching you get crafty and messy. We got Andrew, Michael, Nanette, Sandra, Kathy, Beth, Mark, Jazzy, Lon, Angel, who is Orla, and Anomari. Thank you, everybody, for joining us today. It's going to be a
Great
great show.
group. Yeah, and let me put up the message for the day as well. And it is, serving God and others is a responsibility and a privilege. And the verse is, the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. And that is Matthew 20:28.
A great verse.
It is. Very cool. All right, I forgot to click one more button. All right, we should be set now. Okay, so
Whoops. Oopsie.
totally fine. Totally fine. So I'm going to try this picture-in-picture thing again. You guys seemed to like it so much last time. I'm not sure if the image is right, though, because you can see the. Yeah, I planned ahead. No, really, I've been working on this for hours. Anyway, so basically I've got the big canvas here. It's a couple of feet wide by almost 2 feet tall. And you can see it in grand scale there. Almost fits into the screen. Almost. So as you recall, we did all of the stuff in the last three episodes, and I wanted to point out some things that I did do off camera last week. I know somebody out there is going, you're going to shoot me for doing this, but I really don't do it on purpose. I was sitting here looking at this thing, and there were more to do. I can't fix that. There's just more to do. So let's see. We're going to zoom in, and then we're really going to zoom in so that I can show you what I did here. If I can move the stuff over enough to show you, almost. Nope. Almost. We're getting closer. There we go. Okay, check that out. So here what I did, at the end of the show, I had actually glued the wire down to the canvas, and I did that for all three poppies. And at first, it was a really, really gloppy mess, so I did use a baby wipe and kind of wipe this part up. But as you see, it dried completely transparent, and you can't hardly see that it's there at all. And what's really cool is the wire is glued in, pull it down. It is glued in this position, so it actually sticks up several inches off the canvas, which is really cool.
That is cool.
And then it was suggested, and I thought it was genius, that we add some almost open buds here and there. And so I used a circle punch out of some of those already made poppy papers that we had made. And then some of them I scrunched up into these little buds like this. So hopefully you can see the dimension. They are really, they're glued onto the canvas, but in such a way that they are just like a flower would be. So I really wanted you to see that. And of course, now you can see a good close-up of those beads and that mixture
like
that we had made.
Pomegranate seeds.
Yeah, I agree. They do look like pomegranate seeds. And then we did take our Stabilo pencils. I like how I say we, because you guys were here while I did this. But anyway, okay, so we, meaning the ladies and I, we, you know, just colored in here. And then using a wet paintbrush, I'm just going to show you what I did. I'm going to actually do a couple of more of these. So, but just activated that Stabilo All pencil and created it. By activating it, you just use a wet paintbrush. That's it. That's activating it. And I created those droopy stems that come when you use when you have poppies, right?
Looks great.
Am I still on camera? Okay, good.
Yes, you're fine.
All right, so that's pretty much what we did the whole way around. Now, a couple of these don't have the stems completed yet, so I wanted to do those live on camera here for you guys so you could see them. So we're going to draw with our Stabilo. Just another one of these. This one's going to go in front of that poppy that's right there. Lots of fun doing this. It's quite nice. I want to fix this one. It's not dark enough. Am I still on camera? I got to make sure that you can see that. There we go.
Yeah, you're doing good. Gold star for you.
Yay, me.
And Michael says, poppy papers, yay, a new term. And I was actually thinking sort of when you were saying all that about punching out those papers, that it's punched poppy papers, kind of like Peter Piper, you know. We could make up our own little thing there.
You guys are nuts.
Okay,
so generally speaking, almost all of the glitter stayed, as you can see in those poppy centers. Look at that big glob of glass glitter on each color.
There's the
color
another alliteration.
I got the color the color just changed. Is that nuts?
Uh-oh. They're still pretty, even if the color's wrong.
That's so irritating that it does that. I was so mad at the end of the last episode. Let's see if it'll change back. No? Maybe if I zoom out some. That's so frustrating that it does that, though, because it changed at the and I realized at the end of last episode that the colors were totally off. Huh. I don't know how to fix that now. And I shouldn't be focused on that, I realize, but it's aggravating me because you guys need to see how pretty these things are. Oh, man. Let's see.
Here we go. While you're doing that, I'll throw this up there.
All right.
Andrew's jumping on the bandwagon here. He says, Peter Piper punched a peck of poppy papers.
Very good, Andrew.
That's very good.
Very good.
I'm going to try one more
Peter
thing.
Peter Piper picked a peck of poppies, but I like to punch the poppies better.
Yeah, that's good. Mm. That Andrew, we depend on him for naming.
Oh, there you go, Heather.
There. Yeah.
Okay, don't nobody move. Everybody hold your breath. Okay.
Hold your breath, yeah.
All right, well, hopefully it'll stay. If it changes again, you'll have to holler, but anyway. So that was the bottom line with the Stabilo pencils, and you can just see how that worked in different places here and there. I'm afraid to go close up again because we'll change the coloring. But, oh well, we'll work with it. Anyway, so I wanted you to see the poppy centers are all those, it is a solid chunk of glass glitter, and I achieved that by taking the 3D matte gel and globbed it into those centers and then covered it with an enormous amount of glass glitter. And I wanted you to see what I shook off, what was the excess that turned out to be, I don't want to say garbage because I'm going to use it for something else, but I wanted you to see what was the excess so it's not waste, you know? But this is how much was left after all of that. When I covered all of these with the glass, covered these with beads, this up here and here, and this one here, this is the jar that I ended up filling with the excess. And can you see how much is in there?
Wow.
It's really not that much. It's maybe a quarter of this jar, but not quite. It's more like a fifth of the jar, I think. Can you see just how much is without it falling out, I guess. But anyway, I just kind of thought that was something neat to share because the bottom line is you don't waste a whole lot when you do the way that I showed you. And honestly, it's a lot more glass gel and little bits of beads is all.
It looks so much like the center of a poppy, too.
It really does.
Yeah, I think we nailed
choice.
It on that. Yeah, I think we nailed it on that. So the things that I wanted to add this time. Oh, go ahead.
I was going to put up another quick comment from Judy. She says, don't worry about the color changing. For me, it's more about the techniques. And I agree with that, even though she went on to say, well, I guess it is about the color since it's a color challenge. But I agree. It's about the techniques and the learning while we're here.
And then Andrew's getting all, he's waxing philosophy on us here. He's going close up changes. I'm trying to get that up. Here you go, Andrew. We'll get that up there. He's got going close up changes the reflective aspects of the piece and thus causes a color change. It's a physics thing, it's not an equipment thing.
Well, of course. Why didn't we know that?
Yes.
Oh my gosh, that's hilarious. Okay, so I'm just adding in places after the Stabilo dries. I don't know if you've noticed, but the Stabilo pencil, once it dries, it has kind of a more muted, faded look to it, and so I really wanted to make sure that that cloud was more defined there than it had been. I really liked how this one ended up. Let me see if I can point to it without the. I like how this one ended up. I thought this was perfect, yeah, and this good. One kind of looked blurred, so I really wanted it to be more defined. So that's what we're going to be doing, is just adding details like that to the piece for the show. So some of the things that I wanted to add are, remember we had used down here for this mixture, I had actually taken the Color Lab spray that I made. It wasn't really a spray, it was more like an ink pot, and mixed it with... I think it was matte gel. I think it was 3D matte gel that we mixed it with, which is really cool because it left some of those peaks, you know, when you added the circles here and there, it left some of those peaks, and that texture is still in there, but it is matte. And that mixture that I had some gold shimmer in it. Remember these pots that we made and it had the gold shimmer in it?
Yeah, that's a yummy color.
Yeah, you can't see it, though. Mm-hmm. Can't see it at all. So what I thought I would do to maybe bring some of that back is use soft gloss gel and some terracotta rust embossing powder.
Ooh.
From Lindy's Stamp Gang. And the reason why I'm going to do this is because all that yummy red stuff that you see in there is actually pigment powder. And so we're going to play... with some pigment powder and soft gloss gel. So this is another way you can use your embossing powders. Stretch them a little bit further than just emboss with them, because when you emboss with these, you get a very different effect than you will with what we're going to do today. So be aware of that. If you're buying it to emboss and get this effect, it will not have the same effect. So just to be clear, it's soft gloss gel we're going to use.
But how nice to make our supplies do double, triple, or whatever duty, that they can create more things for us.
Well, that's kind of the point, I think. And I try really hard to do that with this show. It doesn't always work out, mm-hmm. but I do try. Okay, I just realized I can't access the little paint pots that I usually use. All right, we'll just make this work. So... my mini cups, I find these in the, where you would find tin foil and Ziploc baggies and stuff. And I buy these little solo cups. They're lots of fun to play with. Look at that yummy red.
Mm.
And it's got some gold shimmer to it, so it's going to be lots of fun. And we're just going to put a little bit in there because we don't really need a ton for this, for these details that we're going to add.
I was so surprised when you did the open the box on this and you actually did do the embossing, how different the colors look.
Yeah, it's quite insane. Lindy's Stamp Gang mm-hmm. embossing powders are nothing like anybody else's embossing powders. That much we know now.
Yeah. And radically different whether you emboss them on dark cardstock or light cardstock, too.
Exactly, exactly. So it's almost like you get three for one if you use it this way.
Yeah.
Four, maybe, if you just added water instead of a medium like we're going to do now. Because we are going to, I promise. I just can't find my little scoop-it spoon. Okay. We're going old style. Seriously, folks, I actually was up until 3:34 o'clock this morning. And if it shows, it shows. That's all I have to say to that.
That's just Heather's improv, that's all.
Okay, so now this is going to be a little bit granule because the embossing powder in there will not, you know, mix into the gel. Like, it's not water-soluble. Like the pigment is. The pigment is the water-soluble part. I think we're going to actually, because I wasn't able to scoop it out properly, we've got a little bit more medium here than I would like to have. And of course, like always, I will take pictures when it's over with. I'll update the blog post. That original Color Challenge blog post is where I'm putting all of the updates. So if you're looking for a supply list or any of that, you can see all those updates in one place. Let's add another scoopful. So again, it's granular because there is embossing powder mixed in here along with the pigment powder. So you will see granules, but that's okay. So it won't fully mix in is what the point is, what I'm trying to say.
It just adds to the overall effect and kind of gives it texture.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was going for. I mean, we really want this to be a very textured mixed media piece, and I think we've achieved it quite well this whole month, huh?
For sure. Definitely.
Okay. So my point is to just kind of... I'm just getting the excess off is what I'm doing here, but my point is to just accent some of these rings that are already on here so that they will have some glossiness to them, maybe even add a little bit to the petals here. And if you need me to zoom in, I probably can do that.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Yeah. This is digital, so it's fine. Where in the world is my controller now? Man, I'm just telling you, everything is just going crazy today. Okay, well, fine. I'll just do a little zoom.
Maybe we did too much Wonder Womaning ahead of time and just freaked
out.
Oh
my gosh, the Wonder Woman stuff. That was hilarious. Okay. Okay, so this is it on screen?
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
All right. So basically, I'm just adding these details. Now, when they dry, it's not going to be that creamy pinkish looking thing. It's going to actually be glossy and have some shimmer and shine to it. So that's what we're going for here. In case you're wondering, what the heck are you doing, Heather? Stop it. You're going to ruin it.
No, never entered my mind.
Yeah, lies. I know you better than that. I also hear the comments that people
leave.
Yeah, I know. I also hear the comments that people leave on the YouTube channel when they say things like, "I had no idea where you were going. I was even screaming at my computer screen. Don't do it." But in the end, it all works out. Do I need to zoom out in order to get these other sections? I'm trying to move it so that we can see it better, but
yeah, Peg says it's gonna move. Put this up, looking really good. It is, Peg. It's looking beautiful, isn't it?
And I'm gonna add them to the large petals too, just because you can always use a little bit more shine, right?
Of course, bling, shine. You know, follow that stuff. You are off camera.
Of course I am. Thank you.
It's tough when you're working with that big of a piece.
Yeah, and I could totally zoom out, but I don't think you guys would see everything. Maybe you would. Should I just go back to zooming out? Was it okay?
No, you're fine.
Okay.
We like being up close and personal.
And I know I'm off camera again. I'm trying, I promise. Note to self, large canvases for live TV, not great idea.
But we sure have enjoyed this one this month.
Angel's going dibs on the canvas.
Apparently, I cannot paint and talk at the same time. My apologies. I lost the color again. I'm just not going to let it bother me. Got to get my equipment figured out. I really do. It's driving me nuts. Go ahead.
Peg says, it's okay, Heather. I was getting gloppy this morning, too. Pay no attention to the hecklers.
Yeah, exactly. I love when Peg gets gloppy.
Peg's been having fun getting gloppy all over the country.
She has, traveling lady.
Yeah, attending a lot of seminars and classes and
I know. Did you see that picture of her with Wendy Vecchi? Is that her name?
I know. Yeah.
I'm not jealous, not at all.
I think she has her picture with everybody. She's got it with Tim and Diane. And oh, my gosh. I want to be
when I grow up. I know. When I grow up, I'm going to be Peg's traveling companion. That's what I want. I'll fit in a suitcase. It's a big suitcase, but I'll fit in it.
This is a nice comment from Jazzy I'm going to pull up. It's very sweet.
It is.
She says, this month has been super, Heather. So much fun to see you work through the whole creation. And it really is. I agree, Jazzy. It's really great to see.
Thank you. That's a really nice thing to say. I wonder sometimes if my show topic choices are good or not. So I appreciate the feedback. And you know what? It won't hurt my feelings if you say, please don't ever do a show like that again. I'll totally understand. Am I actually doing this where you can see?
Yes.
Yes, yeah, you are.
Yeah.
Okay, so it doesn't look like much now, but in the places where it's drying, it's looking pretty good.
Oh, God. Peg just said that she's got a class with Dion Dior. Come on and go with me. I took an online class with her, Peg. Remember my watercolor class I took? I'm not done with that.
I'm not jealous. Not jealous at all.
Peg will do wonderful in that class.
Okay. I think I'm done, and then I go, oh, no, wait, one more right there.
Yeah.
I'm thinking I'm going to do a little bit of daubs here and there. These ones are really off in the distance.
Oh, I like that. I want to see this dry.
Yeah.
All right. I will take pictures, I promise. I've been taking some pretty good pictures, I think.
Yes, you
have. Yeah, you have.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I think I may have figured out my stupid phone just in time to get a new one. It's dying on me. What kind of phones do people have out there? Because I would like to know what I should get and what I should stay away from.
I love my Samsung Note.
You have the
Note? Samsung Note. Yeah, it's huge. I love it.
I have the Samsung Galaxy S5.
Oh, well, that one's out of my league, ma'am. When I grow up,
I was going to get the Note. I was going to get the Note, but my carrier had a better deal if we went with the S5, so that's all we did.
I hear you. Yeah, I don't have a carrier promotion that I can take advantage of, so I have to buy it, whatever I do. And I wanted the Note, but I can get a better deal on the S4.
Oh, yeah.
And somebody is going to tell me what they're doing right now. I know it.
Not yet, they aren't.
Okay. Well, yeah, you got to wait like 40 seconds or something like that. So it's all good. Okay, I promise I'm done with this step. Moving on. All right, so as those dry, it won't take long. You should see it before we're done with the show. Water bucket. Praise the water bucket.
Peg's got an iPhone 6, and Angel has the iPhone. Michael has a smartphone, nothing dumb.
Oh, well, that's why I need to get a new one, because mine is dumb. It's not smarter than a third grader, you've heard me say before. So that's
Mark
why
says he loves the mirror cast. I've never heard of that.
I haven't either.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
I know mine's going to be an Android. That's all I know for sure. I'm not getting an eye anything. There's someone's phone now.
I know. Sorry about that. I forgot to turn the sound off.
You're fine. You're fine. I was teasing. I really was teasing. Okay, so moving on to the next step of the texture that I wanted to add to this thing. And in order to do that, I'm going to have to flip it around, which means the camera's going to wig again. And we're going to actually zoom out for this, because there's no way I'm going to get all this on camera.
Gwen has the Samsung Galaxy Stellar. She has a great camera, but no flash. I want to get the Galaxy 5, though.
Okay.
Linda has the Galaxy 4 going for the 6.
Oh. Good so grief. By the time I can... By the time I can get a phone, you guys are going to be on 12, and I'm going to be going, okay, I got the 3. All right. Well, the color is off again. Shocking. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. Speaking of that wonderful lady, Wendy Vecchi, right? I'm going to be using her archival ink, aquamarine. These are new to the store if you're curious about these. We've got great inks in the store, finally. Yay. And I think those are linked, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
They're live. Yes. Yeah. You can go check out all the work the ladies have done with pictures and putting it all into an easier-to-purchase format. It's quite cool. So I've just got a grid on my fingers here. This is just a grid stamp, and I'm going to randomly put these in, avoiding the clouds. And I know I'm going to be off camera for some of it, and I apologize, but it's the best I can do right now. And the reason why I wanted to do this is because as I stared at this thing over and over again, I saw nothing but raindrops, like it was raining constantly, which is fine, but that wasn't what I was going for. So I want to break up some of those drips with some of this texture background. And I've got some words. This is like a jumbled word stamp. It's not, that's not proper. It is more like torn text. So it doesn't have any words that you can read, but it adds great texture to the background. So that's what we're going to add here. Here and there. And these are going to be very subtle, but they'll help break up some of those drips. So it doesn't look as much like a drippy, rainy background like it did. Especially here.
Peg says she got a cheap $40 Android LG for her husband and it works great.
Yeah, that's what my husband needs. He's like, Heather, I want to go back to a flip phone. I don't want any more of this internet. I don't want any more of this garbage on my phone. It's so funny. I think I would die if I went back to a flip phone because much of my life is on this thing now.
Yeah, I use mine for everything.
I use mine for everything except for the one thing we probably should use it for, and that's calling people.
Exactly.
I have the absolute worst time making phone calls.
It makes calls?
Yeah, that's what they tell me.
It's a phone?
Oh, yeah. That is what they tell me, yeah.
Oh, that's the same thing Belinda just said. She says, I have to get better at this. Throw myself out of the room too easily. Maybe I should just go with a phone that just makes calls.
Yes, that's exactly.
But that's no fun.
Belinda, I want to say thank you to you because you tweeted about the show last week or this month, and you're telling the world about it. I really do appreciate when you guys do that kind of stuff. I know several of you have done that. Just Belinda has stuck out to me because I don't remember seeing her in the show. So I feel bad because I didn't know she was here, and now that she's here today, I have to make a point of saying hi.
Yay, Belinda!
Brownie points for Belinda. Okay. Nice. Very good. Very good. Okay, so I think... I'm not sure if you can see them, if it's even a valid thing to your eye yet, but I'll try to do some close-ups so we can see maybe the texture in there.
That looks good.
Mm-hmm.
So now you can see those marks a little bit better if I hold
still. You know what that almost reminds me of is like you put text behind it.
Yeah, that's kind of what I wanted it to look like. That's why I use the same color. So, okay, here's a technique moment. We haven't had much of that today. Here's a technique moment. In order to make it look further behind, you want to use either a lighter color or the same color, tone on tone. And this was pretty close to the same color as the sky. Mm-hmm. So I thought it would work really well to make it look like it's further in the back as if it was there all along, right?
Yeah, that's the way it looks.
Absolutely.
And honestly, that was supposed to have been added several steps ago, and I forgot. But it all worked out, because what I really wanted were these white, happy, puffy clouds, and I don't think that would have been achieved properly had I done the stamping earlier on, like I first intended to do.
Right.
Looks okay. Great.
It was all meant to be.
I think you're right.
Different techniques how to do things, and I think that's excellent.
Yeah, and don't panic if you miss something. I mean, really, I missed using the gloss gel and making these more glossy than they were, but we went in afterwards and fixed it, I think.
As I recall, last week you couldn't find the gloss gel.
Yeah, I know, and you want to know what happened with that? I know I blamed you ladies, but you want to know what happened?
Sure.
Well, okay, I have a new helper in the store, so you guys need to know what's going on. When you place an order, the first step is I print out the order from the computer, and when I just realized that I could talk to you up here.
Hi, Heather. Hi.
When I print out the order and then I put it onto a clipboard, and if there's several orders, then they go into kind of like a queue behind the clipboard. And then Travis, I'm sorry, I'm not supposed to say his name. You didn't hear that part. We'll just edit that out and post. T-Dog takes the order, the clipboard, and he actually turns it into a process. Like he adds things to it and clips a thank you card to it and all these different things that he puts on it so that that way it will go through the whole process with all the pieces attached. Then he goes over to the store shelves, and one of these days, really soon, we're going to have a store tour so you guys can see what the store shelves really look like. That'll be fun. And he goes over there and he picks the product based on the order printout, okay? Once he has done that, he then takes that product in a basket and puts it on the packing table, where I then pack it all and check and make sure everything is exactly what you ordered, wrap it in the little paper packaging like I always do, and then put it in a box and ship it off to you. That's the way it works now. Well, in his helping, he actually moved several of my items out of his way and put them underneath something. And so at one point after last week's show, I said, he goes, how was the show? I said, it went great. I just couldn't find my soft gel. All the glossy stuff is missing. And he goes, oh, oops. Sorry. Oops. I know right where that is. So, yeah, sorry I blamed you ladies. Sorry about that.
Well, at least he knew where it was and fessed right up to it, though. I mean, yeah.
What is hilarious is that he knew exactly what I was talking about. That's the part.
Yeah,
hilarious.
That's right. Yeah. But my husband would say, "What?
You lost the who? What?"
Yeah.
All right. I do see a spot here that I really want to put some more in because I can't stand that look right there. So there we go. That's better. Now I'm happy. Okay. All right. So the only other thing that I really wanted to do to this whole mess was add some bling, because now it's been a long time since I said this, and I realized when I was writing a blog post last night about my Tag It Tuesday. Hey, I should show you that.
Woohoo! Yes. Oh, yes. Yeah. Show it, because it's so pretty.
What the heck did I do with the darn thing?
You just had it.
Ask T-Dog. My word. I just had it. Are you kidding? Oh, I said it out of the way on purpose. Okay, here we go. So this is the Tag It Tuesday submission that I did for Sherry's Tag It Tuesday. And the thing was rain, right? Or showers?
Rain, showers, yeah. April showers.
Yeah, so I actually did April showers bring May flowers, and this is my tag. Now this thing is humongous. Look at that. This is much more like...
What? She sells those tags in the store too, right?
Are I do. Uh-huh. I do. Yeah. Yes. So I took a number 12 Manila tag, and turned it into this. And if you're wondering how, it's all on the blog. But anyway, I was writing that, and I realized I haven't said this in a long time. But this used to be when I first started Kraaft Shaak. This used to be the motto when we were like a come to the shack and actually play with products and whatnot. The motto was, when in doubt, bling it out. So people would be sitting there going, does it need something? And I would always go, bling. You need bling. So I'm pulling out the bling.
We'll just put a little comment up here from Mark. And he was saying, is that small monitor showing Heather new? It really makes the show even better when we can see her too. Bravo.
Yes,
thank
I
you.
Agree,
it
Mark.
Is
That's
kind
wonderful.
Of sort of new, isn't it? Yeah, mm-hmm. I appreciate that. Okay, where are we going to put these?
Yes.
Should they be a part of the medallions or in the sky?
I'm thinking the medallions, but then again, that would be expected. So you
yeah,
gotta
I
come
think
in
I'm going
sky.
In the sky. Yeah. I'm going in the sky. Yeah. Not because I choose one over the other, but because I think I'm
diamonds
be going
in the sky.
Yeah.
Oh, here we go again. We're going to start singing 60s songs.
It's the first one today.
All right, let's see where I want these to go. I'm not even totally sure. Now, I will admit to you guys, off camera, what I will do is pick these up and put a dab of the gel underneath just so they'll stay, because I would really hate for the owner of this canvas to pick up their canvas and it all fall off. So I will do that off camera. I won't make you suffer through that.
But Heather, are those actually like rhinestone type things, or are they sequins?
No, they're rhinestones. This is actually, I think, a package of these. Oh. You know, I can't remember. I can't remember if these came from Close to My Heart or if they came from Joann's. They're probably from Joann's, to be honest with you. There's like a package of a whole bunch for like $1.99 or something.
Pretty
or
colored.
Somebody out there is going to tell me, no, they're Close to My Heart, so then I'd be wrong, and that's fine. It's happened once before in my lifetime.
Oh, mercy. Michael says, you are calling it bling, but I know it is really bedazzled.
Yep, a little bedazzled will do ya. And I think I'm going to take a few of these darker ones just to add some...
Oh, that's going
to
be pretty.
Uh-huh, sure. And just when I think I said few, it's going to be way more than a few, I'm sure. I don't know if you can even see them. Do they even...
Yeah, we can see
them.
The light catch... Oh, man. Ooh, temperamental.
Oh, it went back, though. It went back.
Yeah, I cannot go... There's a radar threshold level of... If I go too far up.
Now remember, it's not your equipment.
Right. Oh,
it's
see?
Reflectivity.
Okay, very back good. Down. Okay.
Down,
don't
down.
Nobody touch the canvas. Okay. So the only other thing that I had left to do to this before it was completely finished, of course I am going to sign it somewhere, but I wanted to actually make these a little bit less floppy. I do like how floppy it is, but I kind of feel like there's too much movement here. That bothers me, and I could just see some stinking little kid ripping them off. So, well, the kid who rips off my art is definitely a stinking little kid. I don't feel that way about all kids. Okay? I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, if somebody's going to do that to my art, they're a stinking little kid, right? Okay. So I'm just going to take some of that 3D gloss gel on the end of a palette knife, which, by the way, we sell palette knives now. I'm so happy. Anyway, I'm going to lift up these petals as they are there. And I'm just, I don't know if you can even see what I'm doing, but I'm just putting just a tiny bit. It's kind of like butter on toast a little. Anywhere that it happens to be loose. But not, I don't want to glue them all down. I just want them to be more stable. So I hope that makes some sense to those of you watching. And if not...
Another option would be, too, if you wanted to maybe not necessarily just hold them in place, but maybe give them more lift, is to use a little bit of foam tape in between layers.
Yeah, for sure. I definitely could have done that, but I know for a fact I don't need more lift. This stuff... These guys are way off the page already, so lift was not my goal. Okay, so see, right away I can tell that that's going to stick a little bit better. I feel way more secure about that. And you know, to be honest with you, these tiny little stems, it's so unrealistic, because you know darn well if that poppy was out in the field and this is what was holding it up, it would go onto the ground. So, and this one is pretty good, but see that movement? Can you see that?
Yeah.
Because it's just a staple holding those together. So obviously I want to add some to this a little bit. Again, just a little bit of butter underneath that piece of toast right there. That's all it is. Everything always comes down to food, doesn't it?
To food, I know, and now we're all going to be hungry.
All right, now I just accidentally got a little glob here, and rather than messing with that, I'm just going to add some more of this yumminess to it. And it's looking pretty good where it's dried. I am liking that. Okay.
You're at 15 minutes, by the way.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So I'm just going to add just a couple more blobs to this toast over here. I think that's going to work great there. And you know what? I just contaminated my
what?
Thing. Can you see that?
I did that with glass glitter the other day. Dumped a whole glob inside of it.
Oh, no.
Yeah, not cool, right? Okay, so let's just put the lid on that before I do something very similar. And one thing that I did want to do was add some beads here. After all the beads came off, I realized that I just wiped it on my face. I just wiped this on my face right now. Okay.
The new kind of makeup now in the store by Heather.
Okay. Your makeup.
I'm telling you right now, guys, the picture-in-picture, it's not working for me today. Okay. Right. What I was trying to say was that after I had added or removed the excess beads off of the other areas, I noticed just how stark this one was, and I kind of thought it wouldn't be this big of a deal, but it seems obvious to me. So I really want to put one in the center here, just a big glob. And this is that contaminated, so this is a little bit of red in there, but that's okay, because we're going to cover it with the beads. So we're not on my face.
So oh, come here, on.
Yeah, I know, I'm no fun today. Okay. Oops, that was loud. Any ideas what I did with? Oh, I know, there's a whole basket of goodies that matched for today's stuff, and I left them down here. Okay. So we will just add, again, those turquoise beads. And I'm just going to put a bunch there in that center. And you know what was really cool? And I don't know if you could see this on camera, but I had glued some of the ones that were kind of, that had fallen away. I glued them in place. I'm going to do the same thing here. By just taking a little bit on the end of my palette knife and just kind of blob randomly here and around, and that.
Because that looks cool when it looks like they're kind of falling. Mm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's kind of way I saw it. I think it was you who suggested that too, Sylvia. And if not, take the credit for it, because you did great. Okay.
Yeah, I think it was. So I will take the credit
She's
for it.
She's like, yeah, it was.
Yeah, yeah, no big deal. Pat on the back. We do have a question in the peanut gallery. Oh, sorry.
Chat did I say this was a Q&A session? I did not mean for it to be. No, I'm kidding. Go ahead. What's the question?
Lon is wondering, can you use something like hairspray or clear lacquer to stiffen the poppies?
To make them so they weren't just floppy poppies?
Floppy poppies. Nobody likes floppy poppies.
Oh, no. I don't know why you wouldn't want a floppy poppy. I think the floppier the better, but okay.
Oh, gosh.
I don't know. I don't... In the sense of where they are right now, like the state that they're in right now, I don't know that either of those would actually make it stiffer. Hairspray specifically. I really don't think hairspray would help this situation at all. But Lacquer probably would, but I don't know that you'd like the end result because it would only be sprayed on the surface rather than the whole piece. I don't know if that makes sense. Did I make it sound like I knew what I was talking about?
Absolutely.
Absolutely, yes.
Well, you girls get paid well to say that. So anyway, okay, so I think that's it. I think this is the end of the show right here because I've just got to let that dry. And, of course, the end result will be just like this one up here. I've reached the threshold, the color-changing threshold.
Yeah.
Anyway, I don't know if that gives you a good overall view, but I definitely wanted to show you what it looks like down here in these areas where it has dried glossy.
Oh,
see if
okay,
I can
cool.
do it without dumping all the beads. We're above this threshold of color. Oh, no. It seems fine.
Oh, boy, that really is
cool. Look at that. You can see me moving the camera. How cool is that? Okay, let's see. Can you see the shiny parts where it's actually picked up some of that shimmer?
Mm-hmm. Looks great.
Anyway, you know me, I'm going to probably add more to that.
Nanette is saying that hairspray would probably yellow over time, too, so.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. And not a lot of time. Not like some things, you know, take 100 years to turn. That would probably turn way faster. It's been my experience that hairspray is not the fix-all, even though some people do claim that it is. That's just been my experience.
I know it stops flies dead on their tracks, so that's cool.
Maybe okay, I need to just wander around with a big old can of hairspray. Would it would take care of my mosquitoes, too?
It probably would because it stops their little flappy wings from flapping.
Oh, my gosh.
Of course, there, my dogs would be sneezing like crazy.
Yeah, this is what happens in the mosquito land. There I was, flying along, had my target in sight, when all of a sudden, I was stopped dead in my tracks. I couldn't move a muscle. Okay.
Oh,
and I leave you with that.
Yeah.
I leave you with that, friends. I think we'll say goodbye. And I appreciate you joining us for Kraaft It Live. I really hope that you've enjoyed making this as much as I have. Well, you didn't really make it, but you definitely helped. I could say that. You guys really did help. So I hope that this has been fun. I hope that you'll look forward to joining us next week when we announce May's Kraafters Challenge, and you just never know what that's going to be about. But I bet if you registered right now for those episodes, you'd probably get a clue because I've already titled them all. Hint,
excellent.
Hint.
Yes.
So anyway, yeah, go check that out. Be sure to register so you get the email notifications. If you're watching this in recording on YouTube or wherever, please subscribe, give us a thumbs up, let us know that you liked it, and if you didn't, don't tell me about it. I don't want to hear it. No, I'm just kidding. I love criticism. Really, I do. Anyway, you have a fabulously crafty day. If you can't do that, then, you know, pay for somebody's craft supplies so they can. Everybody have a great day. We'll talk to you later.
Bye. Bye, everybody.
Have a good week.